Okay, so today I'm gonna be giving you guys a tour of my digital art workspace. A lot of people have been asking me about the kind of equipment that I use and the setup that I've got, so I figured I might as well make a video for you guys to cover that instead of trying to reply to every single comment. So here it is, I'm gonna be giving you guys a look at my setup and what I use to create digital art. Okay, so right off the bat, here is my drawing station. This is where I complete all of my artworks, and the centerpiece of this is the Cintiq Pro 24. It's a great tablet, it's got a 4K display, it's got great colors, and it works really, really well for all of my artworks. But I do not recommend this tablet because it is about $2,000, and on top of that you have to spend like about $500 for a stand. So if you're not actually making a living from your art, I really cannot recommend spending that much money and making that kind of an investment on something like this. There are a lot of other options out there for you to go a little bit cheaper, but I do like the bigger size. So if you can't go cheaper and get something a little bit bigger, maybe go for something that's like 1080p instead of 4K, I would really recommend that. Now, speaking of this tablet, you're gonna notice that I have it propped up at this almost vertical angle. This is just what I prefer when I'm drawing so that I can move my hand around a lot more easily and I don't have to hunch over with my neck, because looking down all the time gives me a lot of neck pain, so I don't want any of that. And what's allowing me to prop this tablet up at this angle is the Wacom Flex arm that is behind it. So I have it clipped onto my table, and the arm is great because it allows for a lot of mobility for this tablet. I could shove it off to the back if I'm not using it. I can bring it all the way to the front. I can tweak it so that it's facing different angles. So it's very, very flexible, and I really like that for this workspace. Now, this tablet is not going to work on its own because it's not an independent computer, but you could get that component for this tablet from the Wacom website. I just didn't. I'm using it with my 2017 15-inch MacBook Pro, and this is actually the laptop that I got for my design work because I'm studying graphic design in university right now. And so when I started doing more of this art thing, I just started using this laptop for using Photoshop as well as editing a lot of my videos. Now, the MacBook Pro has been great so far. I work off of it for pretty much everything, but the only thing is when I'm editing my videos, when I'm rendering my videos, and when my files get a little bit large in Photoshop, the fans on this MacBook starts going crazy. So I'm hoping to be able to upgrade that eventually. And on the left side of my laptop, I have connected with it a Samsung portable SSD. It's got a 1 terabyte storage, and I work off of it with my Photoshop files. Because I produce a lot of files, the laptop's 256 gigabyte storage is just not gonna cut it. I've got a stand underneath my laptop, as well as a keyboard that is separate from my laptop. This is the keyboard that I use for all of my shortcuts when I'm painting, so I can move it around really easily and use it right in front of my Wacom Cintiq Pro. And I've got a mouse to go along with the laptop. This is the MX Master 3 for Macs by Logitech. And this thing has been really, really great for me because it allows me to speed up my workflow quite a bit, and it's really comfortable to use, much more so than the trackpad, so that's a plus. And you've probably also noticed some of the small things that I have on my table. This here is a glove from Huion. Now, I love these gloves because they allow my hand to glide across screens really easily, and it helps me to be a little bit more free with my gestures. And this here is a cleaning cloth that I got from Huion as well, and this is just in case my screens get dirty, I have something on hand to be able to clean it. And right here is the pen for the Wacom Cintiq Pro 24. Okay, so you probably noticed by now that I'm not actually sitting down in a lot of my videos when I'm drawing, and that's because I've got a standing desk right here. And the reason that I got a standing setup is because I found myself sitting down for long periods of time, and it was starting to really take a toll on my back. And you know, once you hit 22, your back ain't the same no more. So I did some research, I looked into this a little bit, and I bought myself a standing desk. And this has been probably one of the biggest changes to the way I work, because now that I've got a standing setup, I could sit down when I want and stand up when I want. And it's been really good for my back, because now when I find myself sitting down for long periods of time and getting a little bit uncomfortable, I could just press a button, have the table raise up, and continue to work. Okay, and speaking of standing desks, I've got a sponsor for this video. Let me introduce you guys to FlexiSpot. They sent me this table right here, which is also a standing desk. And how these desks work is you have them connected to a power source. They've got two buttons. One is for down, one is for up. When you hold the down button, the desk will move down until it reaches its lowest point. And when you hold the up button, it'll move up until it reaches the highest point. It's very simple, very easy to use. You could stop the table at any height that works for you. And what I use this station for is basically what you see right here. All of my video editing is done at this station. I basically bring over my MacBook Pro when I need to edit a video. I plug it into the monitor and I can start working on a bigger screen, because I find when I work on a small screen, especially for editing videos, it causes a lot of strain on my eyes. So this monitor and the station really, really helps with that. So now this has made my work process a lot more enjoyable. And I want you guys to know that I actually went and bought a standing desk on my own before FlexiSpot even reached out to me to sponsor this video. And honestly, it's probably the best investment I've made in my entire workspace aside from this big boy right here. Now, for those of you guys who are curious about my YouTube setup, it's honestly not that much. I have a Rode VideoMic Pro, and everything that you're seeing right here is being shot on a Sony A6600 that I got on sale. I always catch the good deals. And I've also got a tripod to go with it. It's just a really simple tripod that I got from Amazon for this camera. And you can see some lights back there. I think this is a newer LED light that I got from Amazon as well. I use it mainly as a fill light, so you can see a little bit of that on my face right there. Usually when I'm facing the window, there's gonna be a bit of shadow on the side of my face. And I use this light to kind of just fill in that shadow a little bit so there's not too much contrast on my face. But that's honestly my YouTube setup. It's pretty simple. It's a Sony A6600 with a VideoMic Pro and a couple of LED lights, as well as a tripod from Amazon. So I think that just about covers everything that I've got in this studio space. It's a pretty simple setup so far. And if you guys are looking to get one of these standing desks for yourself, I have a link down in the description for FlexiSpot. They're actually giving you guys a bit of a discount, so be sure to check it out. It's also gonna support the channel a little bit. But if you're not in the market for one of those, don't worry. Just by being here, you're already helping me out a lot. And over here, I've got a print from my print job and some shoes. But that's pretty much it. I hope I answered a lot of you guys' questions about the equipment that I use. And yes, I'm always standing when I'm drawing. That's the secret of a good posture. When I'm sitting down for a long time, I find myself hunching a little bit too. Oh yeah, and this chair is a very unremarkable office chair. I didn't even buy this myself. I don't know what brand it is, but anyways, that's pretty much it for the tour of my studio. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. I hope I was able to answer all of your guys' questions. And if you want to see digital art content where I actually draw on the setup, be sure to subscribe to my channel because that's the majority of what I do. But other than that, I'll see you guys on the next video. Oh my God, my hand is so tired from holding the camera. I'm never doing this again.